Good evening. My name is Mallory Chen, and I'm the ladies' drill sergeant of Sankofa.
Hi, I'm Sam Stakely. I'm the drill sergeant of the Kofa Men. I want to welcome you all to the Sankofa Spring Show Call Time. It's a very special year for us because this is the 20th birthday of Sankofa as an organization. All 20 years completely student run. We're very proud of that history, and we've put together a show that looks back on that history and thinks about how to engage with that in the present and also look forward to our Kofa future.
So I want to take a moment to recognize all the beautiful alumni we have with us tonight. Thank you guys so much for your continued love and support. We are where we are and who we are today because of each and every one of you. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts. This is for you guys, so please enjoy.
Kofa, run! This! last step was dope as hell. Yo, that step was dope as hell. Who made that? Where'd that harp music come from? Yo, what's
going
on?
Be not afraid, my son.
You're not my dad. Who are you?
Who do you think I am?
A piñata, Big Bird.
I'm the Kofa Bud.
Okay, Kofa Bud, where are we?
This is a dream, your dream. Listen, every year, a Kofa senior is chosen to embark on a spiritual journey to discover the true meaning of Sankofa. Kofa, Kofa.
Wait, hold up. So what you're trying to tell me is I'm the chosen one, right?
Yeah, here's the thing. You were, how can I put this lightly? You were a special case. Listen, I've called upon the spirits of Kofa alumni to guide you as we revisit moments of your Kofa past and look towards your Kofa future. Let's go back to the beginning.
Well, learning how to step, I think it all starts with just having rhythm and having that ability to move. And that was something that I think that I brought from the start, just like a desire to move and have fun moving. So then it just became about moving in the right ways and stepping as a way of moving in very specific ways. But I think it just started from that, like, love of dance and rhythm, and from there, like, you just gotta practice and just gotta learn.
So, the ladies drill sergeant my freshman year was Anika Denny, class of 2013, and she was a very effective drill sergeant. That being said, it was one of my most terrifying moments as a newbie, and also probably of, the 4 years on the team. She used to do this thing where she would have one person perform in front of the team, or even two people kind of like battling against each other. And I was not very good my freshman year, and so having to be this one little scared little freshman who didn't even talk, like stood in the back of the studio to learn the steps, like having to perform by myself and getting yelled at to be louder and louder and like hit yourself harder, and you're trying to remember the steps and you're trying to impress Nika and you're trying to impress the team and trying to not have a terrified look on your face while they're screaming like, give face, and you're trying not to just like have these like wide eyes, like just like leave me alone kind of thing. So that was very, very scary. And I think it was an effective way to teach for some people, but it was, yeah, equally as terrifying as it was effective.
Yeah, choreo, but I wasn't like performing it. They were like, you're not stomping loud enough and you're not being big enough. Like you have these like long arms, use them. And I would be like by myself, just like Pete, be bigger. Like Pete, stomp louder. And I remember having like, I can't do it. And like, they're like, no, do it right now. And so I would like stomp my foot. And it was like, that's not loud enough. And I was just standing there like all alone. And like, so Jabs was one of our drill sergeants. He's like 6'5". Like, it was like, stomp louder. And I was just like, it was so scared. Like, I don't cry easily. And I like, was like my voice was wavering in that moment.
First time like I saw Sam get tight, Just because, like, just because I had to learn that, like, he just sort of gets tight, but, when I, like, I don't know, like, as drill sergeant, I just sort of, like, I expected, like, his authority to be, like, omnipotent. So I think, what, like, the second or third time I was late to Saturday practice, I was like, oh, I'm gonna get the hammer now. And that was actually, like, the time, like, that was the one time I was early to practice, and then we all did wall sits, and I was like, wow.
You get the newbies in, kind of showing them and teaching them the steps, and then it's so surprising, and not even surprising, but it's so nice to see how each and every single time, after a few months go by, they just run with it. And they're like so in love and so enamored that they're just like going hard, like coming up with their own things. Because
performing, for me personally, has made it all worth it. Even though, like, I struggle during practice and it's hard keeping up with everything, but I just have to keep in mind that, like, it's worth it in the end. And it's like nothing beats performing and have everyone comes to you like, that was so dope. Like, it feels good.
Experienced it every year where the newbies have this moment of like being pushed to the max, and then they either push through or kind of close up, and then I eventually push through. So
I how nice of an environment it is. I thought y'all were so exclusive when I wasn't part of COFA. Yes, but now I don't feel that way.
Because you're part of COFA.
Remember those days?
Yeah, it really feels like it was just yesterday. I really feel like I've gotten better, you know? My paddle hands are tighter, my angles are sharper.
True, you've gotten a bit better, but do you really understand what stepping is? Listen, everything from the way we stomp to the way we clap comes from somewhere, has connections throughout history and to the present day. There's so much more for you to learn.
Thank you.
It's using your body as your instrument. It's pushing the limits of what your body can do, what you can do with sound.
Step is a great opportunity to make music, just kind of layer sounds upon sounds upon sounds upon sounds, and just hearing how all of that can mix is just something that I've always enjoyed. Plus also, just there's something about being able to get information and, be a sort of unified sound. So you have that one very powerful sound comprised of a group of people doing the same thing. I think there's something powerful about the performance of that. So.
The first time I saw Lao Ne do a step where he made sound hitting his back, I was like, holy shit. Like, I'd never even thought of doing that before. Like, what? But the first time I saw John Withers, he's just like class of 2010, he made a step incorporating karate moves into it. I was like, what? Like, I'd never even thought of doing something like that. You know, like, the more that I see stepping, the more that I see people bring themselves to stepping and respect it as an art form, the more excited I get, because the more things I get to see that I never thought possible. So
the connection from sort of this sense of emancipation and saying we are, very much like what we were just saying, we are America, and this is a new song that we're making.
Gumboots as a dance form was created in South Africa in the last century when African men from various ethnic groups from the countries of South Africa, Lesotho, Botswana, Zimbabwe were brought into the South African gold mines. And they were given Wellington boots to wear because of the water and, you know, the debris that was accumulating in the mines. Mine work is very dangerous, and it was even more dangerous then. So the men had to develop ways to communicate with each other and also to be in sync. So people developed ways of communicating with limited common vocabulary and also with sound signals, right? These artists shared material. And so gumboot found its way into black dance companies.
You have to respect it. If you don't respect it, then you severely undercut its development as an art form and your potential to grow within it.
What do you think?
I mean, that was cool and whatnot and whatever, but Kofa doesn't really do that anymore, right? We're more like the...
OJ.
What's good?
How old are you?
20.
Okay. I bet you've changed a lot, you know, over the 20 years, right?
Yeah.
Just like you, Sankofa has also changed over the last 20 years.
How?
I know. Let me show you.
Interesting to see how the steps not necessarily change fundamentally, but stylistically and different kinds of things aesthetically that the group does that's different from maybe before. And so
first joined, it was maybe more traditional step forms, like a lot of angles, a lot of repetition. And if you look at other step teams, sometimes what's so impressive is the precision and like the togetherness and just how it looks like one movement, like dead across. And I think there were points on the team where it was kind of like that style.
There's probably a little bit of edge that was happening from when I started to when we ended. I think the previous performances that I've seen of old recordings were very like, lively and energetic, but also very happy, as opposed to with a little bit more attitude, a little bit more edge to it, which I just like as a performance element.
I've seen rhythms get more complex in some ways, and like syncopated, and especially when we have musicians on the team. And I've seen other dance forms kind of bleed in. Freshman year, it was really close to original forms, and by my senior year, it was very like interdisciplinary, collaborative, and mixing different dance forms.
So like at a certain point, you can look back at old Sankofa videos and be like, you know, that was the point where like using props was really big, right? Like the canes and the sticks. Or at another point where it might have been some other kind of style. But definitely, I think with that, as you see each group come in, there's always something that you can attribute either to a person or to a group of people that were in Sankofa at that time.
Thank you.
not too shabby. When we start using props, when did that become a, thing?
I mean, it pops up every now and again. We've evolved a lot since, 96.
96! Yeah, but like, when we gonna get to that, kofa la, kofa man grit, a little bit of a shimmy.
So you wanna get to the shimmy. All right, listen, have you not listened to anything I've said since you've fallen asleep? No? All right. So you want to get to that nitty-gritty stuff? We will. We'll get to that. But first, like I said, there's so much for you to see.
Okay, Olade?
Yes, Olade!
Yes, baby! Yes, baby! Yes, baby!
Bye.
To go see a lot of different performances. We've been, you know, more closely supporting other dance groups in the department. And people have really branched out a lot in a way that's like very atypical for step, because there's that like very classic sorority fraternity style stepping that, you know, we do get influenced by in a lot of ways, but then in other ways we've kind of thought outside that box and use step more as a dance medium. To do some really cool creative stuff.
I also think that one of the things that was kind of more introduced as we went along was more of like a storyline, which is something out of my experience, but it was something that a lot of other people brought to the table, which I think was a good thing. And I think was part of an evolution of Sankofa, that there was more the fuller sort of storytelling within and around the choreography.
The more steps and styles that we have to choose from, the more dynamic and the more options you guys are going to have in terms of your performance and your ability to adapt to the different places and spaces that like invite you. So I always think that is beneficial to keep finding ways to grow, because it just opens your horizons in terms of like where you can perform and what your performance is going to look like.
But it will always be what it needs to be for the people who have it. Over time that changes, and that's real. It's uncomfortable for some, it's great for others. What doesn't change is what it made you feel and what the people made you feel. What it doesn't change is how much you love and respect them.
Yeah. It's about breaking the stage, and I think it still is.
stress is always keeping in mind that marriage is the most important. A marriage can be a source of joy and love and mutual support. But why do we teach girls to aspire to marriage and we don't teach boys the same? We raise girls to see each other as competitors, not for jobs or for accomplishments, which I think can be a good thing, but for the attention of men. We teach girls that they cannot be sexual beings in the way that boys are. Feminist, a person who believes in the social, political, and economic equality of the sexes.
You wake up, housed up, run around in it, blossom on it, your diamond, my diamond, the rock, my rock.
Thank you.
That was intense. You know, Kofala really did their thing out there, but you and I both know who the best squad is. Kofa man.
Yeah, here's the thing. As Kofa bud, I'm required to state, according to my contract under Article 2, Section A, Subsection 3, that both teams heretofore in respect to their skills, talents, abilities, and prowess, henceforth known as swag, are both equally able, capable, relatable, and delectable.
All right, whatever, Mr. Kofa Bird. Well, you control this place, right? Can we have some fun? Take me to last year's step competition. Yeah, yeah. Oh, and the after party, too. Hey.
So you want to see a step competition, huh?
Yeah.
You mean like this?
And now, the performance you've all been waiting for. Your favorite step team. All the way from Williams College, it's Sankofa!
We got that name from, are the co-ed social event for COVID. So it's when we get together and we drink and we party. Am I supposed to say drink? I don't know if you're allowed to say that. And we step, because it always ends up with us stepping for 500 hours. So there's that. It's like the fun outside of practice and shows. Okay, one line I specifically remember a lot because it's not that, it was very different from all the other lines that we did. Was one we did in Dowdy, my sophomore year. We didn't step, we just were like enjoying each other's company and like being ridiculous and making all these goofy faces. So I really enjoy, like I enjoy our usual things of like stepping and being loud and things like that, but that was just nice because we just sat around for hours. You should make up your mind.
know that one of the ones that I always really valued, and I think that it's because it gave you that space outside of practice time to bond, the Kofa Limes, where it was just a time to kick back, relax, get together with everybody. And it was always a fun time. And I think that everybody made the point of going, and that was one of those times that, yeah, guys have their separate practices, girls have their separate practices, but it was that time where we would really all come together. And I always really liked, I loved those when we would have the lines. I don't know, it felt more like it created that sense of unity among the group.
You are free.
That was fun.
I think I broke some, but I'm a little surprised. You got a little pep and step in them feathers, huh?
I don't know what you're talking about. It's kind of a little dusty, and I haven't done this in a while.
Nah, you killed it.
Oh, listen, we're running short on time, so let's get back to business. Where was I? Remember the retreat? So every year, current members get a chance to sit with recent alumni to remind the current members and to teach the newbies the history of Sankofa. Sankofa was founded in 1996 by a group of five women of the class of 2000. We began practicing informally in front of Chapin Steps before officially joining the dance department in the year of 2000.
Family and Sankofa are two things that are synonymous. You can't really have one without the other. It's what makes it so easy to commit to, even when it seems really difficult. And it's the thing that keeps you coming back.
Remember, I would just like sit in Preski doing some work, and like Randall and Corey and MMC would roll through, and we'd like go get lunch together. We'd go to like the mashed potato bowl in Mission, and I felt so cool because like all of these like cool people wanted to hang out with me, and I was like, oh, this is great. And it was like, you know, starting to feel more like I belonged in it.
I think our 15th year reunion, that came out so strong, that in a way it felt like family. We were steppers, but we were family, and like sometimes it felt like we were more family than it felt more like a family than like just a step team.
Once I began feeling more comfortable at Williams and feeling more comfortable on the team and feeling like a real part of the team, that's when I sort of really began to feel my relationship with COVA changing and growing for the better. And by the time junior and senior year came around, I really felt like part of the team. I felt kind of like an integral member. Like I had all these connections to these different people who I otherwise probably never would have met or come across on campus. And that makes me very, very happy. And I feel very lucky to have gotten the opportunity to meet all these great people. And I'm so happy that my relationship with COFA and to COFA and everyone on the team was able to grow and improve throughout my years.
I also think I had, like, my freshman year, this upperclassman was really good about bringing you into the fold. So I always had people, like, looking after me, and I was kind of like, they would show up to my room and be like, what are you doing right now? And I'd be like, why are you here? Like, I don't really know you. And I think, like, by the time that I really spent, like, a full week with the team, like, those connections, like, allowed me to feel more with it once I just finally decided to, like, invest the time.
Just performing with, the first time ever performing with the group, you just get a sense that, okay, we're trying to be a unity, and in that mission, we're ending up becoming like a family. And it's just important, like when you do like a team sport, whatever this you want to call this, and you're constantly thinking about another person that's not just you. You're like, okay, I'm trying to match my sound, my speed to like this group of people. Then you start thinking of yourself as one.
Reunion is a set of steps that everyone in Sankofa ends up learning during the time on the squad. Reunion is also the perfect step to get current members to reconnect with the past and remind us to keep stepping forward while looking back.
What?
Man, that was really powerful.
Yeah, and it's about almost time for your show. I'm gonna send you back now.
Yeah, man. My last one at that. You know what? I'm gonna go out there, do the show, and then what comes next? I'm about to graduate, bro.
I've seen a lot of you come and go, and it'll be hard, but you'll make it. You're gonna go, the team will continue to flourish, and when you come back, you'll be proud of how far they've come. Listen, I'm gonna have to send you back now, but first, let me show you a little bit of your Kofa future.
For so long, you have this creative space when you're in Sankofa, and then you graduate, and it's like, where do I put all this creativity? But also, it was my stress reliever, and it was my time to sit back and like catch up with people that really meant something to me. You know, people that were friends, but more than friends, they were family. And I remember after graduating, I just felt like this withdrawal. Like, man, like I really miss stepping. I miss performing. When I graduated, I ended up becoming a high school teacher, and I had a couple of girls that came up to me one day, and they were like, Miss, like, we heard you used to step in college, like, Miss, you gotta start a step team with us, we gotta do it. And it, like, I was just like, yes, let's do this, and it was, like, that became, like, my pseudo, like, replacement for Kofa, because it was just like that one, again, it's busy, and I have a busy schedule, so I could only do it with them once a week, really, But like that once a week time of just like getting up on the stage and like that teaching them steps or seeing them collaborate together, like that was kind of like my replacement. I'm like, oh, this feels like home.
Sankofa was a large part of like my foundation, you know, like the friends that I had, like awesome, love them, always will, forever. So like not having them in close proximity, like I can walk down Hoxie Street and find Lonnie and just sit and talk, and now Lonnie's in Botswana. You know, like, or I could run into Fran and come out of a CC meeting and just like go to eat some grill, and now she's somewhere in the South. I think she's in Atlanta or something. I don't even know. See, I don't even know. Like, it's difficult.
The last step of the last show, we did Where's My Remix, and I remember walking out and I was so emotional, and in the beginning, like, ha, ha, ha. I just started, like, I had tears, like, flying out of my eyes, and it was probably like the most feeling I put into any step. Most of my closest friends are still our Kofa people and beyond. Like they've become not just my close steppers, they're my everythings, and we get through life together. And there are people who I don't speak to. One person I have, a friend, I haven't spoken to her for a year because she's in med school. And then we talk on the phone and it's like that. And after we graduated, we all came back for a homecoming once and we decided to relearn a bunch of the steps that we had done in our senior show so we could get together in the studio and do them all together just for fun. And like, I step in public with Mindy and like anytime we see each other, we bring out old steps or like play with choreography. So it doesn't ever go away.
Stage, please. Thank you. OJ! 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 OJ!
it's gonna be when we come back and see how cool Kofa still is. Now there are gonna be some things that change, but at the same time there are gonna be some things that never change. Kofa is always gonna be Kofa.
Alright, y'all.
But you're trying to come on.